In one of the many corners of YouTube sits an unassuming channel with three videos, each testing a different computer-generated art form. These videos are the remnants of a forgotten art career, one belonging to Kui Asuka, also known as Suki Baby. She dropped this interest to instead focus on her adult dancing career, performing at the club Onyx and posing for photo shoots. Even though Suki had left behind graphic design, one of her photos found its way onto one of 2022's biggest albums.
I just put this album out, I've never performed it before. I thought we're better than Atlanta, Georgia with my brother, if that's okay with y'all.
Drake and 21 Savage posted the same picture of Suki Baby on their Instagrams, announcing the cover art for their collaborative album, Her Loss. The project's opening track, Rich Flex, quickly became one of the standouts, abruptly combining multiple instrumentals into one song. It was put together by the producers Vinyls, Take Heath, FNZ, and Boogs Da Beast. I went through Rich Flex and looked at how three of the different instrumentals used here compared to songs made by each producer earlier in their career. So let me show you what I found as we listened to Drake and 21 Savage's Rich Flex.
21, can you do something for me?
21.
Can you hit a little Rich Flex for me?
The release of the album, Her Loss, was a surprise, announced at the end of a music video for a song off of Drake's previous album, Honestly Nevermind. That album was also a surprise in its own way, unexpectedly filled with dance, house, and Baltimore club music. One of the tracks, though, stayed closer to Drake's typical hip-hop performance, and eventually gained enough popularity to warrant its own music video.
Fuck a pigeonhole, I'm a night out, it's a different mode. I'ma have to make a pan of six on a pinky toe. Heard you with a shooting guard, just let a nigga know. I would have your court side, not the middle row.
This is Jimmy Cooks by Drake and 21 Savage, produced by Vinyls, Tay Keith, and Q-Beats. This track is built around a sample of Brooke Benton's 1976 track, You Were Gone. To turn the opening of this track into Jimmy Cook's, the sample was sped up to around 155 beats per minute. And then the pitch is moved up 6 semitones. To build the sample into the finished track, some hip-hop drum samples are added, along with a sub that follows the original bass. Jimmy Cooks was the last song released by Drake and 21 Savage before the two dropped their collaborative album, Her Loss. So it was an open question what tracks, if any, on this new project would carry on this sample-heavy sound.
21, can you do something for me?
21.
Can you hit a little Rich Flex for me?
21.
And 21, can you do something for me?
21.
Drop some bars to my pussy ex for me.
This is the opening chorus of Rich Flex, coming after some spoken intros by 21 Savage and Young Nudie. Not only does it share two producers with Jimmy Cooks, Vinyls, and Tay Keith, but both tracks also make use of samples. Here in Rich Flex, the original song comes from the soundtrack to 1973's Invasion of the B-Girls. This sample goes through a process similar to the one in Jimmy Cook's, getting slightly rearranged and then sped up to around 153 beats per minute. Turning the sample into the finished beat is again pretty similar to Jimmy Cook's, adding in some hip-hop styled trap drums and a sub bass underneath. Australian producers Fnatic and Zach, better known as the duo FNZ, were browsing YouTube looking for inspiration when they stumbled across Thames doing a live performance of Higher.
Tell me why you're crying, how can it be deal? When you gave me something I don't really feel.
After flipping the sample into a new beat, they sent it over to ATL Jacob, the producer in charge of Future's 2022 album, I Never Liked You. The Australian duo waited, but didn't hear anything back about their sample, until something familiar came on the radio.
Oh, wait,
Early in the morning, late at night. It don't even matter what time it is.
This is Wait For You by Future, featuring Drake, and produced by ATL Jacob and FNZ. Here in the intro, you can hear the sample of that Temps performance, which appears throughout the track.
I will wait for you, for you. I will wait for you.
It seems like FNZ took the sample and sped it up somewhere around 85 beats per minute, and then moved the pitch up maybe a half step.
Wait for you, for you.
It seems like the producers didn't leave the sample here completely intact. If you let it play out normally, when it loops at the end, it should sound something like this.
I will wait for you. Girl, babe.
I would guess that FNZ didn't want to hear this jarring vocal every time the sample looped, and instead replaced it with some reverse guitars from elsewhere in the track. To get this sample sounding like Wait For You, I added some pretty heavy reverb, but that was it. It didn't seem to need any other instruments. This performance by Temps is the foundation of Wait For You, and needs almost nothing else to make for an impressively calming track. A similar style of straightforward sampling could be a good way to put together an interlude, maybe interrupting some already aggressive instrumental.
Why my ass be posting guns and only use they feet? Hey, like an athlete, I got
all you hoes, all of you hoes, need to remember who y'all talking to.
This is the second part of Rich Flex, an interlude sung by Drake. I don't actually know if FNZ added the sample here or anywhere in Rich Flex. The production credit could mean anything, but looking at the songs they've made before, they probably brought in one of the two samples used here. We already saw how Invasion of the B-Girls was repurposed for the first part, and this time in the interlude, it's a sample of Sugar's 1973 track, I Want You, Girl. After taking the sample out of the middle of the track, it seems to be sped up to around 153 beats per minute and lowered 5 half steps. This interlude in Rich Flex seems to only be made from this sample, similar to that Temps performance in the intro of Wait For You. Although here, the sample's vocals are put in the background, with Drake instead taking the lead.
To remember who y'all talking to, it's the Slaughter Gang CEO.
Who got the meats and roots?
Memphis rapper Black Boy JB was just starting to get some popularity in 2017. Working with fellow Memphis producer Tay Keith, he had set off a dance craze with his track Shoot, and followed it up with another hit, Rover. These songs caught the attention of Drake, and Black Boy was launched into mainstream success with their surprise collaboration on the track Look Alive. So when Tay Keith saw 21 Savage listening to Rover on Instagram, it wasn't crazy to think that he could get the rapper on a remix.
Slaughter Gang, we came to shoot your kid back up. Nigga disrespect me, he get shit bagged up. We done with her, come and pick your bitch back up. I ran off on the plug and I need pit back up.
This is Rover 2.0 by Black Boy JB featuring 21 Savage and produced by Tay Keith. The track is based around this piano loop. This piano is pretty loud in the upper frequencies, and only ever seems to play two notes at a time. The simplicity here is balanced out by the rhythm, which keeps a lot of these chords hitting in between beats, with the syncopated pattern smoothed out by the drums. These drums seem to be made from some usual trap hip-hop samples. There's a hi-hat on the eighth note, a snare on beat 3, and a kick that lines up with the sub-bass. As Tay Keith gained prominence and continued working with artists like Drake, he brought with him these pianos and drums, the sounds that he had started with in Memphis.
Hello, you need to find you someone. Ay, 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 I'm on that Slaughter Gang shit.
This is the final part of Rich Flex, and has the most aggressive instrumental so far. Again, I can't be sure which producer worked on which part of the track, but the pianos here seem to have a lot of overlap with those by Tay Keith. The piano here sounds just as harsh as the one in Rover, with a pattern that's just about as simple. There's an upper part repeating the same two-note chord, and a lower one, also playing two notes, in an offbeat pattern. Alongside this piano sits some equally similar drums. Again, this part has a lot of overlap with Rover. The hi-hats and snares are nearly identical in their sound and pattern, while the kick has been swapped for an 808. That covers the three different beats in Drake and 21 Savage's Rich Flex. I did skip over an intro by 21 Savage at the beginning, but it uses a different part of the same sample that shows up in Drake's interlude.
No, we walk around the world, stepping out, giving a damn by where our feet land.
To recap what we heard in each of these beats, I remixed this track with some new instrumentals that use the same ideas as the original song, starting with the sample-heavy sound from part one. The sample here is the same one used in Drake and 21 Savage's Jimmy Cooks, just taken from a different part of the track. To further match Rich Flex, I added in a sub bass along with some trap drums, including a kick, hi-hat, and snare.
Bitch, call your dad, bitch, call your uncle, bitch, don't call me, always in my ear, your whole fleet, why my ass be posting guns and only use they feet, hey, like an athlete, I got...
The second beat was brought in with an abrupt transition. Again, it was sample based, with the one here coming from that live performance of Tem's Higher. We saw in Future's Wait For You. Besides some pitch shifting and filtering, there didn't seem to be much else added in this part of the song.
If I'm busy, then fuck no. You need to find you someone else to call when your bank account get low. You need to find you someone.
The third beat here was again an abrupt transition, this time going into the most aggressive instrumental, using some Memphis pianos and trap drums, similar to those in Tay Keith and Block Boy's Rover.
Man, niggas seeing me, I'm young, money CMB. I used to roll with CMG, the house is not a B&B. The bad bitch is waiting on a nigga like I'm P&D. I'm steady pushing P, niggas pushing P.
That finishes this new group of beats and how they look into Drake and 21 Savage's Rich Flex. I think jamming them together in this short format makes their transitions even more jarring than usual, but each of these new instrumentals still seems to capture some of the different faces hip-hop can take. Maybe you can use these ideas in your own music, or just listen to this track a little differently. Thanks for listening. Leave a comment and let me know what you think of Drake and 21 Savage's Rich Flex. Don't forget to subscribe to Sound Selection on YouTube, check out the podcast, and follow on Instagram.